Many people don't know where buses come from, where they got their start. Some people think they come from here, the local bus yard.
Well, actually, I happen to think that they come from here.
You're stupid, Kevin. Shut up.
First regular bus service in the United States started in New York in the year 1905 using lengthened automobiles. There are three kinds of buses. Inner-city buses, which carry passengers, mail, and packages between towns or cities. There are local buses, which are city buses, and they carry thousands of people every year. And school buses, which are self-explaining. And special buses, charter airport buses, and tour buses. Senior busologist Kevin Frolix.
In the 1820s, there were 12 passenger horse-drawn carriages in New York, which was really the start of public transportation. Then in the early 1900s, there were more public transportation modes when the popularization of automobiles was popularizing. The first bus created was known as the omnibus, which served all people, but they had to pay a fare to get wherever they wanted. Those early buses were built by truck manufacturers and were made to carry very heavy loads and were generally poorly built and had a very uncomfortable ride. But that was until the 1920s when they made real buses that were built closer to the ground and had better suspension and such for a smoother ride for those passengers.
But the real question here is why this man, prefers Prevost to MCI.
There are many bus companies that use the Prevost buses, one of which is the Premier Coach Company. And why wouldn't they? Because all of the Prevost buses have extra-large panoramic windows, reclining seats, individual reading lamps, a restroom, a public address system, a multi-screen video system, AM, FM, and cassette stereo, overhead storage racks with generous luggage capacity, and plus, it's air-conditioned. There are also available magazine pockets, individual tray tables, window shades, and a wheelchair lift. Another thing that makes the Prevost buses so much better than MCI is the fact that they have a heavy-duty frame, as well as a superior electrical job. When opened up, you can see that the Prevost buses have a much neater and clearly numbered wiring job inside, whereas the MCI buses have disorganized, and it was clear that the level of care in the Prevost buses was a lot higher than that of MCI when you look at these two factors. But it's not just the wires, it's the use of all electrical components in the two different buses. Each system in the bus is optimized for both performance and maintenance. The Prevost is really in the seated coach and tour bus business, where downtime for problems costs big dollars and angry customers.
Sorry, Will. We will conclude this with a live dramatic reading of a letter written by a Prevost enthusiast, as read by Will Gunn.